Hi everybody, David Dilling from Markzware, and today we're going to talk about preflighting. Why do we need to preflight? Firstly, Markzware, we created preflighting niche back in 1994 or so with FlightCheck. The term preflight was coined after a man by the name of Chuck Wagner, and like, you know, borrow from the airplane, you know, aeronautical industry. Before you take off, you want to do a preflight check. They do a preflight check, at least we hope when we fly, to make sure everything's going to be okay for the flight. That helps, you know, greatly reduce the likelihood of a catastrophic problem. Unfortunately, in design for print, there is quite a few problems. But we do have the ability to stop these problems. And why do we do that? Because look at this chart here. One problem can create a whole host of waste and costly errors. So it's very important to preflight at every step in the workflow and to preflight yourself at every phase, major phase within the design process, whether it's every page of, you know, every day. You have to look at that yourself, how you actually do that. I know people that preflight just about every image before they put it in a file. It's, you know, maybe going a little too far, but hey, it's actually really smart. Don't have much time, so we're just going to cover the top main preflight problems. What are they, and how can you maybe stop them or be, you know, at least be aware of them? Missing things, missing images. Well, missing images is, of course, quite logical. If you don't have the image available to embed in the PDF when you export the PDF, or the image available for packaging, you know, if you have an Illustrator file you want to patch it together, send it to a printer for some packaging you designed. If you don't have the image linked or the image is missing, you won't be able to package it. The printer won't be able to print it. Print it properly. It might be there on screen, you see it, but it's actually not physically there. Very important missing elements. Missing fonts, another part of the missing elements. You need to have your fonts available to embed them properly or to package them to send to the next party in the workflow so they can load those fonts. That might include screen and printer fonts. So of course, all different types of fonts. We can jump into fonts, and I could spend probably 20 minutes just talking about fonts and TrueType and all the different types of fonts you could use or not use, and that's a whole other element, but you have to also check what types of fonts you're going to use in your workflow. Overprint and knockout, very important, you know, the overlapping of elements. This is where preflight meets as both a science and an art, which is something you have to look at visually. Preflight will tell you, hey, you have overprint or knockout used on these pages, and you could, like, FlightCheck will take you right to the problems, so you could look at it and check out, is, you know, the color going to be inadvertently, changed because of the overlapping. You know, if you put two colors over each other and have certain levels of transparency or not, it could cause problems. And that's something you're going to have to check yourself. And, you know, the knockout could cause also white borders coming around if the registration is not set correctly, and a lot of other hosts of problems that could happen if you don't do that overlapping quite right. So incorrectly specified colors, very important to check the color model and to communicate with your printer. That's a big tip to remember, communication with your printer or the next party in the workflow. If you insert RGB images used in an InDesign layout or Quark, whatever it might be, make a PDF, and it goes into a CMYK workflow, you're going to get undesired, you know, your red's going to print brown, all kind of weird stuff, you know, so you need to make sure you understand how it's going to be output. Don't use RGB colors in a CMYK workflow. You know, don't use too many spot colors. You don't want to have, you know, hundreds, maybe 30 different colors used if you're only printing a four color output. The more color you use, the more expensive it's going to be. Understand the job. Don't use too many colors. And check the color modes. Make sure that they're, you know, what you desire. Image resolution. Of course, image resolution is very important. There's also the effective resolution. So if you have a file that's going to print properly in a small little box on a US letter size page, and you check it, the effective resolution might be fine, 300 and something DPI, great. But that same image, if you use it a full page, might not be fine. It might be a low res, effective resolution-wise. So that's what we want to watch out for, that the image resolution, not only the image itself is proper, you know, resolution, but the if it's 300 DPI and the size used is also going to be at the proper resolution. So these are very important things to check out. It's a whole science behind that. You're going to have to study that yourself in your extra time. Likewise with scans, when you scan in an image, you make sure the LPI, the DPI, you know, the lines per inch is proper for printing. So if you do a 300 DPI, 600 DPI, that should be fine. But make sure you don't scan in lower than that if you're going to go into print, because it won't print properly. It'll be all fuzzy and, you know, not desirable. These are major problems. You see them in newspapers and magazines all the time. Just take a look at your newspaper and look for missing fonts, fonts that were substituted, or missing images. You'll find stuff all over. Ink coverage. Ink coverage is something that, you know, you think, well, I want black, so I'm going to have everything, you know, 100%. I want, you know, 100% black. But if your ink coverage is too great in any one area, it might bleed through thin paper, particularly newspapers or those thin newspapers that just bleed right through. You know, so you have to make sure that you're, even though if you want 100% black, you might only need 60% black, you know, to get the desired effect. So once again, it depends on the output and the final job. Hey, you have page settings, bleed, a lot of other things you can check for in Preflight with FlightCheck and other tools. Very important to do that. There's, you know, a good tip is to download a FlightCheck or check out another Preflight product out there and look at the ground controls in FlightCheck or the Preflight profiles and other tools and look at all the problems you can check for. And of course, a combination of two can also be a problem. So Preflight is very important in the workflow. Henry Ford created the assembly line process back in the early 1900s, and you know, printing is also a manufacturing assembly line process, and quality assurance like Henry Ford introduced is also being used at the print shops to some degree. That degree varies on which print shop and, you know, what workflow they have. So it's important for you to do that to help stop these problems, you know, before they get downstream. If you put a low-res image in, it goes all the way to print, it's going to cost a lot of time and money for somebody, and hopefully it's not you. So Preflight, save your reports, let it be shown like a court record you did it right, and pass on the next party in the workflow. Thank you, David Dilling from Markzware. Hope this has been useful. Check out our stuff on www.markzware.com. Good luck with your study, and have fun.